like we can see you.
Wait, I bet you don't even see us. Where's she at? Oh, you never look at her.
Yeah, I wish they'd stop.
Only if you wave back. Tell her only if you wave.
Okay. Have your attention. At this time, I'd like to call upon Reverend Roberto Rojas for invocation.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful evening you give to us. Thank you, O Lord, to blessing. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with us tonight. Amen.
At this time, I would like to call upon Michelle Butcher to lead us in singing the Admiral King High School alma mater.
Hail to our colors, gold and blue. Hail to our alma mater true. Throughout the years we shall stand by. With pride we'll keep your standards high. The values we establish here will make our memories ever dear. Oh, Admiral King, so strong and bold, light that you've created here will be our beacon through each year and bring us always home to sing the glories of our Admiral King.
Okay, class, will you now be seated? There's a few items I would like to now review and more or less as information for the audience. Number one, I'd like to remind us here this evening that this is a ceremony of dignity and it is honoring the graduates here this evening. And we'd like to have you remain off the track. This is being taped and it will be televised. So those of you who are interested in seeing this ceremony will have that opportunity at the later date. Secondly, I'm also would want to remind you that you can exit either north or south from the parking lot. The gates are open at Washington School upon leaving. At this time, I would now like to introduce to you our honored guests who are behind me and ask them to stand when I call their name. First, Mr. Kosciusko, Vocational Director of the Lorain City Schools. Mr. Beckler, Business Manager. Mrs. Brumback, Treasurer. Dr. Demian, Executive Director of Curriculum Instruction. Reverend Rojas, Reverend of the Spanish Lutheran Mission. Dr. Lohr, Personnel and Labor Relations Director. Mr. Ed Siniger, Vice President of Lorain Board of Education, Pepper Martin, Superintendent John Pavick, Jack Tillich, Counselor of Admiral King High School, and Wendy Langendurfer, Public Information Officer. Thank you. I'd also like to recognize for his extra efforts in putting this function on here this evening. Mr. Jack Tillich has worked very hard, and I appreciate all the time that you've spent to make this event as nice as it is. Thank you, Mr. Tillich. It is a pleasure to welcome all of you here this evening for the Admiral King High School commencement ceremonies of 1985. As the audience assembled, it reminds me that education is a fundamental ingredient embedded deeply in our American tradition. These students, for which this occasion honors, have enthusiastically and intensively completed their necessary formal education. This graduation ceremony gives credence and strength to a job well done by the young men and women seated before you. This class will be remembered as one of the finest classes to have received their education at Admiral King. They have been characterized as being dedicated, cooperative, hardworking by many professional and support staff members at the school. These traits, they will find, will be the necessary fiber and strength that is required throughout all of life as they commence upon new challenges that will now lie before them. I am sure you, as well as I, wish them luck as they meet these tasks. Service plaque and honor graduates. Of all the honors this school can award to its members, none is considered more important than the recognition of being named to either the Admiral King Service Plaque or being recognized as an honor graduate. It is a tradition to have the principal read the list of those seniors in the top 5% of their class in each category at commencement. The Service Plaque. There are numerous opportunities for young people to contribute to the operation of this school during their four-year high school career. They may earn service points by participation in music, athletics, dramatics, clubs, publications, student council, teachers of office aiding, ushering, concession stand working, etc. Those graduating seniors who, of all members of their class, have made the greatest contribution to the school will now be listed in numerical order, ascending to the person who has the most service points. The students will stand as their names are read. I will ask the audience to withhold their applause until all the Service Plaque Award winners are standing. The Service Award winners are Tracy Rakich, Kevin Castro, Timothy Garrick, Michelle Kurtz, Adrian Harris, Anthony Altamari, Princette Burnett, Cheryl Bansick, Cheryl Pierce, Mark Orlandi, Lee Gelb, Janica Kinda, Holly Williams, Melanie Collins, Robert Smith, Althea Suggs, and number one, Tabitha Watson. Please give them a round of applause. Will you please be seated? We are proud of those pupils whose names have just been read as the ones to be engraved on the service plaque, but we are doubly proud of these outstanding scholars whose names will go on the twin plaque to be displayed in the halls of Admiral King forever. The names of the honor graduates will also be given in numerical order, ascending to the student who ranks number one in this year's class. Will you please again withhold your applause until all students are standing? The honor graduates are Michelle Butcher, Melissa Cabranes, Robert Smith, Mark Amato, Mark Hickman, Molly Woltman, Bruce Davidson, Mark Mahalik, Deanna Soltes, Lisa Freeman, Judith Aegis, Christine Oraz, Janet Kakinda, Debbie Dargo, Anthony Altamari, Marla Desatnik, and number one, Mark Orlandi. Please be seated. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you the superintendent of the Lorain City School, Superintendent John Pavick.
Thank you, Dr. Coleman. Ever since I've been superintendent, it seems to me that Admiral King's lived under some very lucky stars. They haven't had a rain day since I've been here, and I can't say that about the other high schools. Matter of fact, I understand that it's only been three times in the last 24 years that we've had a bad bout with the weather. I'm happy to be here to share this evening with all of you, and I'd like to commend the parents and the members of the community for their support of our public school system that ensures a quality educational program for all of these young people. I'd like to also extend my congratulations to the students of Admiral King High School for the successful completion of 13 years of education. You know, if you look at the program, it says commencement. And the word commencement often causes some confusion, and perhaps it's right and proper that we clear up this confusion. We know that the root of the word is commence, which means to start up or to begin, and yet it's apparent that this is a graduation, which marks the conclusion of your school careers. And how can an ending be a beginning? And yet the answer is very obvious. This evening is an ending, a conclusion of a process that was begun 13 years ago, a process called formal education. Throughout the time, these students have worked and studied and exerted considerable effort for this particular day, the day that the studies are completed and they receive a certificate which attests to that fact. This day has come, and now the conclusion of their schooling is at hand. But just as certainly, tonight is also a beginning. Why did everyone here go through 13 years of schooling? Let me suggest it was not to prepare them for an ending or conclude a portion of their life, but they were prepared to begin a new life. This evening, I greet these people as citizens of the world. You do not end your life as a student as much as you begin your life as an adult in an adult world. With this new position, which you assume tonight, go many rights and responsibilities, that's true, but also come many awesome responsibilities and demands. The very fact that you've completed your 13 years of education and are here as part of the audience tonight suggests to us that you're ready to accept these responsibilities and demands. Certainly, that's the fervent hope of our faculty and staff of the Lorain City Schools. Therefore, take what you've learned and use it. Use it at this commencement. Use it as you begin your new life as an equal partner in the world. Use it as you meet the challenges. Use it now and throughout your lives. May it serve you well. Now, I'm honored to introduce the three outstanding students from this graduating class. Each of them will speak on the topic that's printed in your program. The first speaker is Mark Amato. He's the son of Mr. and Mrs. Pat Amato, 336 West 28th Street. Pat has been an outstanding student while attending Admiral King High School. He's followed a strong and challenging college preparatory curriculum by taking the honors courses whenever they're available. Mark ranks number 12 in his class of 333 and was recently inducted in the National Honor Society. Mark has also been involved in the band and tennis. Mark has been accepted in the School of Radiologic Technology and will become a radiologic technologist. Mark Amato.
I'd like to thank the National Honor Society for giving me this opportunity. Special thanks to Tim Pelter and Ken Price. We've anxiously awaited this day for what seems like a lifetime. Actually, going to school is just about all we've done with our lives so far. But now that we've reached and passed this milestone, there is something else that we anxiously await and wonder about. It is something everyone thinks about, but I believe it's more important to us, this year's seniors, because we are at the beginning of ours. And just what are we wondering about? The future. What does it hold for us? Oftentimes, we wonder what life has to offer us. We think about what we'll be doing years from now. What sort of life will we have? Perhaps we dream of material possessions such as houses, cars, luxuries, and money. Perhaps we dream more of personal content in the form of happy marriages and family life. Or perhaps we dream of the job satisfaction that comes with an important and prestigious position. If we are not careful, these dreams, ambitions, or goals, depending on how you look at it, build and build. There can get to be so many of them that we start to wonder if these dreams are in fact just dreams, or will some of them actually come to pass. The more we wonder about these dreams, the more frustration there is about having them realized. We start saying to ourselves that it's no use making plans or having dreams because most likely they won't turn out. Perhaps we might say it's best to go day by day and not be disappointed by the future. But we needn't be disappointed by the future and won't be if we make plans and set our minds to seeing them through. If we set our minds to it and work towards it, we can have that house, that car, that job, and that family. In fact, if we do this, there is nothing we couldn't have. And we, the graduating class of 1985, are in the best position to get everything we want out of life. We are at the beginning of our future. We have plenty of time to make plans and complete them. We are fresh out of high school with the ambitions of youth. We are eager to get on with our lives and to show people that we can be self-sufficient, responsible human beings. With what education we've gotten so far and the further education we shall receive, we have the necessary tools to shape the future to our liking. And that's what it is for us to live and experience it the way we want. If in the years to come we find that the future wasn't what we thought it would be, then it's our fault. It would be our fault because we wouldn't have worked hard enough. We wouldn't have completed our plans. The future wouldn't have disappointed us. We would have disappointed the future. Thank you.
Our second speaker is Anthony Altamari. He's the son of Mr. and Mrs. Frank Altamari at 3524 Watson Court. Anthony has received many academic honors and awards, which include the National Honor Society, participation in the Ohio Test of Scholastic Achievement. He's a recipient of a Science Award. He's been on the Academic Challenge Team, and he's been a member of the PLUS program. Anthony's extracurricular activities have included band, ski club, baseball, and tennis. He has the honor of being accepted into the United States Naval Academy, where he will major in engineering. Anthony Altamari.
Fellow students, in a few short minutes, we will walk away with our diplomas, signifying that we have come to the end of the 12-year journey known as compulsory education. Our celebration, however, will be short-lived, as we will be thrust into the real world, a world that expects us to make decisions as an adult responsible for our own actions. Some of these decisions will deal with our future, whether to go to college or into the service, and what type of career we desire are just a few of the many decisions we will face. Of course, we all wish to be successful at whatever we choose. Unfortunately, success will be harder to find in the future. Is there a magical formula for success? A set of keys that will unlock the doors of success? I feel there are a set of keys for success, and is comprised of three basic ideas: taking the initiative, giving it your best shot, and learning from your experiences. Taking the initiative is the first key of success. The phrase, "It's a jungle out there," is truer than ever today. No longer can a person wait for the college he wants to attend or the company he desires to work for to come knocking on his front door with an offer sitting on a proverbial silver platter. He has to go out and look for it himself. However, he just can't look nonchalantly. Today, one has to be aggressive in a search. This means grabbing their attention and saying, "Look at me." And once you have their attention, show them your best and never relent until you have what you want. In order to be a success today, one has to shape his own life, not have someone else shape it for him. The second key of success is giving it your best shot. As my senior English teacher pointed out in class one day, success only comes before work in the dictionary. No matter what type of opportunity is presented to you, you should give it 100%. This means utilizing all of your capabilities, both mental and physical, and pushing them to their zenith. When people take note that you are giving it your best, they will place you in high esteem. Eventually, all the hard work will be rewarded, be it in the form of a college degree, a well-paying job, or maybe just a handshake or a pat on the back from a family member or close friend. Whatever the reward is, you will know that you have accomplished something very important for yourself and have succeeded by giving it your best. The third and final key of success is learning from your experiences. Every day brings new experiences from which you can draw knowledge. Some of these are good, some are bad. A successful person is able to learn from these situations and apply them to his life. The good experiences he will remember and will use the rest of his life, while the bad ones will show him where he was at fault and teach him not to make that choice again. Through this, he is able to constantly improve himself. The successful person also never stops learning from these experiences. He will watch in wonder at new things he learns and will never think that he knows it all. Life is one giant textbook, and in order to be a success, one should keep it open and always learn from what it has to offer. Fellow students, I have given you what I feel are the keys to success. Taking the initiative, giving it your best shot, and learning from your experiences have worked for me in my 4 years at Admiral King. Hopefully, you will think and use what I have said, and maybe one day, we will all see how great a success Admiral King's Class of 1985 is.
Looks like to be a speaker at Admiral King, your last name has to start with A. The third speaker is Melissa Andrews. She's a daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Tim Andrews, 1422 Narragansett Boulevard. Melissa's been very active at Admiral King. Her activities include student council, senior committee, track, key club, and ski club. She's listed in Who's Who among American high school students and was recently inducted into the National Honor Society. Melissa has been accepted at the University of Toledo, and she will study nursing. Melissa Andrews.
Tonight, as we receive our diplomas, many of us will say to ourselves, "Now what?" Graduation is an end. And into 4 years of preparing ourselves for the rest of our lives. Now we are out in the real world. The end of high school is only the beginning of the rest of our lives. Now we will see how important our education really is as we go out into the world and strive to be the very best we can. There is much truth in the saying, education is the key to success. One must have the background in order to further himself. The jobs in today's society require higher forms of education, such as 4 or 6 year college degrees or technical degrees. Without education, success will be very hard to attain. So maybe doing those 20-page term papers or those monotonous computer programs weren't so bad after all. They may have seemed ridiculous or useless at the time, but there will come a time in your lives that you'll be grateful for all the work you were expected to do. The future is ours. We can't determine how our future will be, but with the background we have had here at Admiral King, we'll be the very best we can if we set our goals and strive to meet them. But don't be discouraged by the setbacks you may have in reaching that goal. Learn from them and move forward. Never give up. Each and every one of us must do the very best in order to be the very best. Some of us will go to college to pursue the dream of being doctors, lawyers, teachers, nurses, or many other professions. Others may join the armed forces or go to the academies. Being successful is up to you. Only you know how far you can or want to go. You make the choice. Now we will see that after tonight, there is a whole new world just waiting for us. Don't hold back and give it your all. Never give up on your goals. If you think you can, you can. But if you think you can't, you won't. And as you go out into the world, always remember the good times we had here at Admiral King. These were the best years of our lives. Now is the time to go out and give it your all. To strive to be the very best you can in whatever you choose to do in life. Take what you've learned in these past 4 years and add on to it. Leaving Admiral King is the end of high school, but it is only the beginning of the rest of our lives. I would like to wish each and every one of you the very best of luck in the future, and may you find much success and happiness in the years to come. And now to the community, staff, superintendent, and Board of Education, I introduce to you the graduating class of 1985.
Okay, class, please stand. At this time, I'd like to call upon Mr. Ed Sinniger, Vice President of the Lorain Board of Education.
Thank you very much, Dr. Coleman. My partner lost the notes. On behalf of the Lorain City Schools Board of Education, I would like to express to you, the members of the 1985 Admiral King graduating class, our sincere congratulations. You have successfully completed the course of study mandated by the State Department of Education of the great state of Ohio, as presented by the Lorain City Schools. Sitting in the stands are your many parents, your grandparents, brothers and sisters, uncles and aunts, and friends of yours. Proud of your attainments over the past 12 years you have spent reaching this goal. This diploma could act as a key to unlocking many doors for you in the future. It may and it will assist you as you continue reaching and striving for a better and a good life. Speaking for one and all of us, we would ask our God to bless you tonight, tomorrow, and forever. Thank you.
Okay, class, please be seated. At this time, this is our diploma presentation. We have a couple special diplomas that we're going to be taking care of. The first one will be presented in a private ceremony, and that goes to Mr. Daniel Paskovich. Daniel Paskovich is being granted an honorary Admiral King High School diploma. He is the son of Mr. and Mrs. Conrad Paskovich. Dan attended Admiral King until November of his senior year. Because of an athletic injury, Dan was unable to finish his high school education. While at Admiral King, Dan was an honor roll student in college and honor level courses. He was a candidate for honor graduate, which is the top 5% of the class, as well as National Honor Society. He played football 3 years, doing an outstanding job. For Dan's fine accomplishments academically and athletically while at Admiral King, it is our privilege to award him an honorary diploma. Dan is unable to be here tonight. The diploma will be given to him by a member of his family. Next, I'd like to call up Mr. Hugh V. Pepper Martin. A second. Stay right there. Mr. Hugh Pepper Martin is being granted an honorary Admiral King High School diploma. He attended Lorain High School many years ago, but because of circumstances was never able to finish his high school education. He retired from BF Goodrich with 33 and a half years of employment. He has been a contributing force in Lorain for his entire life. His involvement in amateur boxing is recognized throughout the area, and he is a member of the Lorain Sports Hall of Fame. He also has contributed countless hours since retirement to the tremendously successful Admiral King football and basketball programs, as well as to the school. This is most admirable, thus the presentation of the diploma. Also, as a testimonial, Mr. Martin received a standing ovation at a packed DeLucas Place in the Park honoring this year's Admiral King football team. Congratulations, Pepper Martin. At this time, with the first row of ladies, be prepared to receive your diplomas. Melissa Andrews, Tina Arroyo, Cheryl Bansick, Michelle Barnett, Don Bellarucci, Betty Blackburn, Christine Borer, Laura Brandt, Michelle Bratton, Alicia Brooks, Princette Burnett, Michelle Butcher, Melissa Cabranes, Christina Cabrera, Lisa Cambrera, Yvonne Karras, Lisa Chisholm, Lisa Cicerella, Melanie Collins, Ann Cook, Tracy Crouch, Sean Dabrowski, Ava Dampier, Deborah Dargo, Lucy DeLeon, Mary Dembeck, Marla Desatnik, Betty Drop, Colette Duncan, Kimberly Dunick, Pamela Edriff, Lori Edwards, Judith Aegis, Ellen Ferris, Nisi Feliciano, Suzanne Figueroa, Kathy Fisher, Michelle Flanders, Helene Flint, Angela Flowers, Antoinette Flowers, Renee Fulton, Lisa Freeman, Tina Friend, Bernadette Fursey, Kathleen Gall, Wendy Gary, Lenore Gillis, Kathleen Gilman, Donna Golubic, Sylvia Gomez, Christine Gonzalez, Renee Good, Patty Gringle, Valerie Hardnett, Ginger Hartley, DeMarc Harvey, Renata Horvat, Renee Houston, Andrea Rebar, Francis Jackson, Pamela Jackson, Jacqueline Johns, Cheryl Johnston, Cassandra Jones,
Joyce Lynn Castle. Diane Knight. Shirley Knox. Janet Kakinda. Jacqueline Kinesny. Joanne Karagianis. Teresa Kovar. Lynette Courant. Michelle Kurtz. Deborah Kuzner. Roxana Lamy. Ann Lash. Michelle Lapresti. Rhonda Lauterbaugh. Andrea Lucky. Lisa Lugo. Anethea Lumpkin. Linda Lund. Christine Majesi. Candy Marmy. Lisa Masters. Gwen Mazzaro. Kathleen Meck. Kimberly Mio. Patricia Mitchell. Diane Morris. Elizabeth Myers. Nancy Nichols. Stacy Niski. Diane Knott. Marque O'Brien. Diana Button. Christine Oraz. Elizabeth Ortiz. Karen Payne. Christine Piger. Karen Palermo. Cheryl Pierce. Michelle Price. Yolanda Rainey. Tracy Rackage. Rhonda Ramsey. Deidre Ransom. Barbara Reed. Susanna Reiner. Maxine Rice. Michelle Richards. Elba Rivera. Isabel Rivera. Nancy Rivera. Carmen Roman. Sandra Rouser. Tammy Sikowski. Crystal Sanders. Wendy Sauer. Deborah Saylor. Jane Scally. Tracy Sejak. Nora Smith. Monica Snipes. Wanda Soler. Deanna Soltes. Linda Stefanik. Lisa Stumphauser. Althea Suggs. Catherine Sutphin. Jane Tarkazik. Arlene Traxler. Stella Turner. Anna Velasquez. Rachel Velez. Chris Velez. Audrey Baika. Sonia Waller. Kathleen Ward. Deborah Wargo. Lisa Wargo. Tabitha Watson. Michelle Weitzel. Regina Whitfield. Barbara Williams. Corlise Williams. Holly Williams. Tracy Williams. Kimberly Wilson. Molly Waltman. Lisa Rice. Lynn Rice.
Denise, right. Michelle, right. Jennifer Yontek. Tony Zepeda. Elizabeth Ziemba. And that's the girls. Let's give the young ladies a round of applause. Okay, please be seated. Gentlemen, please prepare to receive your diplomas. Anthony Altamari. Mark Amato. Stephen Bager. Eric Balmert. David Bansick. Kenneth Barlow. Dave Bodnar. Michael Bove. Donald Bullard. Adam Burgess. Robert Carrion. Kevin Castro. Gary Cochran. Milton Cook. Raymond Cortez. Oscar Cruz. John Zomploy. Jeffrey Danovich. Bruce Davidson, Dennis Davis, Charles Deichler, Henry DeLeon, Lawrence DeMonico, Dave Del Principe, Peter DiDonato, Prince Donald, Lawrence Iden, Dennis Fabian, John Figueroa, Gerald Gaddy, Todd Gaddis, Lee Gelb, Timothy Garrick, Mitchell Gillum, Derek Gilmore, Michael Glowinski, Michael Godlewski, George Gonis, John Gonis, Andre Goshen, Kevin Grego, Joseph Guerreri, Adrian Harris, Christopher Harris, Earl Harris, Leander Harvey, Paul Henderson, Mark Hickman, Todd Hollett, Robert Holloway, Arthur Rebar, Matthew James, Mark Jones, Ronald Jerzinski, Michael Justice, Richard Kaplan, Gary Keith, Ernest Kennel, Jeff Kirby, Joe Kiska, John Kanopka, Jeffrey Koski, John Kovach, William Kovach, Demetrius Lee, Jeffrey Lindsay, Daniel Long, Troy Lumpkin, Tyrone Lumpkin, William Lunsford, James Lynn, Bruce McCartney, Brian McCartney, Daniel McQuaid, Frank Medina, Anthony Mio, Stan Michener, Michael Migletz, Mark Mahalik, Todd Miller, Kenneth Mitchell, Tim Moore, William Moore, Joe Morales, James Morrison, Troy Namick, Robert Noon, James Nunnally, Mark Orlandi, Tom Orlando, Osiris Ortiz, Jose Otero, William Overton, Richard Paul, Timothy Pelter, Michael Perry, Jason Peters, Daniel Petticord, Mark Philblad, Frank Polito, Kenneth Price, Daniel Raymer, Daniel Randall, Keith Reber, Michael Riggle, Cedric Roberson, Gary Roberson, Richard Rodriguez, Scott Ross, Jeffrey Roth, Timothy Ryan, Kim Satterfield, James Schomer, William Shuck, Brian C., Kenneth Shedd, Walking Silva, James Smith, Leonard Smith, Robert Smith, Gregory Socha, Michael Spinelli, Scott Stefanchik, David Zabo, Donald Zimmanel, Mark Telaha, Gary Turton, Daniel Banks, Thomas Walkholz, George Walls, Robert Wayman, Robert Weaver, David Welch, Eric West, Jeffrey West, Michael White, Aaron Whitfield, Brian Williams, Jimmy Williams, Otis Williams, William Wilson, Samuel Wingard, Jeffrey York, Terry Young, Dennis Zelina. And those that are gentlemen of the class of 1985, please give them a round of applause. Okay, if everybody's got their hats back together, please be seated. Okay, at this time, I'd like to call upon for our benediction, Reverend Roberto Rojas.
Thank you very much for everything. I feel very happy for you. I am excited, like you are, because you are the future of our country. Our Lord is happy, like you are in your heart. I believe that is your first step. I am glad to be with you tonight. Continue. Don't stop. Our Lord be with you always. I know everybody is happy today. Let's receive the blessing of our Lord Jesus Christ and the God Spirit and the Father. Gear up. Dear sister and brothers, the Lord bless and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up this countenance upon thee and give you the peace. Amen. Thank you.
joining us for Admiral King's commencement. Please join us again tomorrow night at 7 p.m. on Channel 36, where we'll be broadcasting Lorain High School commencement exercises live. Thank you and good night.